Hello, good evening. Such a weird sensation to look into the camera without seeing myself, but it's just another way to have a monologue, which in any case, monologue every time. So good evening, good day. Buenas tardes, buenas tardes, dobry vecher, servus, shalom aleichem, salam aleikum, namaste, all of it, to all those who joined this experience and probably not everyone experienced that life before, because what we have online is just postcards. Postcards from the past. Some of them most drawn, some of them loved by some of you, right? Some of them misunderstood, because we're not all of us can see the whole picture. Quite often we just see a postcard from the past, right? And every time it's just an experience, a present, a gift for this momentum, which has its own quality, its own variation, its own improvisation. So just to add to these few words before I will start touching the strings, is that my story as a so-called musician started from receiving a gift. First, when I was a kid, my mama, papa asked me if I want to study guitar. Привет, мама, папа, кстати. Здравствуйте, дорогие. Спасибо вам. So receiving this gift was like the first round of receiving. But it was okay for a kid to receive it. Kid wants to do other things also. So it just happened to me that I had a wonderful human being, a teacher who picked me up from that age, 8 years old, and started to lay the foundation for what it would become. He saw my temperament and passion already at that age. So he would always find a program of different dances of the world. It could be Cuban dance, Brazilian dance, Arabic dance, Jewish dance, tango, Spanish dance, rumba. It would be all kind of dances. And then this kid left that kind of musical world. He put the guitar aside for about 10 years. And then another round of a gift arrived. And then that kid picked it up and really felt as a kid again. He didn't care about the money, he didn't care about the society around. He would sit on the street and play. And of course money was part of it, but it was not the only foundation for that exploration. So later, when a phenomenon of changing the world came, because the kid saw himself outside of all this society thing, he would just see running people around wearing masks. You know, nowadays we visibly see people wearing masks. At that time, he would just see people wearing masks, looking like normal people, sitting on the street, in this town, in that country, in this or that place, for about 10 years, sitting on the street. Then, of course, the kid received invitations and been playing festivals and big concert halls and exploring every time these infinite variations of a gift. Because what happens in a story when the gift is received? It needs to be shared. It has to be shared. It's not for the kid alone to have it. And so it happened that this kid actually not used to do this thing in front of a wall or a camera or a studio even, because he could even play the same way every time. Every album recorded, it's a variation. Every live performance, it's a variation. Sometimes faster, sometimes slower, sometimes more dynamical, sometimes less. And when those watching it say, wow, here in this postcard you played great, but who have seen other thousands of postcards? Many. The kid been watching it. Whatever that is watching through the kid's eyes, breathing through the kid's heart. And so, tonight, we're going to explore two great aspects of a human life. One of a more so-called dramatic life. A life before 2020, I would call it. Because what happens before such a great event like 2020 or 9/11 or many other events through our history that we know about, though now we do have a direct experience of a change. Change means something has shifted. It will never be the same. What will be directly requires our participation and creation. So life before 2020 or life before any event that changes state of affairs, state of life, state of being, it's more like we walk in with the closed eyes, closed hearts, closed senses, and then something happens, and through that crack this new something enters. So that's my intention for tonight, to kind of present, to share basically that which I have no idea in what way will come out, even though I know some things, but the way they will come out, I don't know. I trust it every time, and now also. So it's just an opportunity to look at the life of a human in so-called first part, to look at the life of a human where we are walking around with closed senses, sometimes feeling, sometimes exploding, sometimes reacting, pretty much every time. And then something happens and we go on another kind of trip where our senses open up, our hearts are opening up. And then we see that everything that we see around, we create ourselves. So I will pick it up from the moment when we finished in Istanbul, in Cappadocia. We recorded a spontaneous little thing that got a name, Cappadocian Dust, which is all dust, this life, in a way. And that would be a variation of it, as the last thing I did when performing live, pretty much. As a journey, not just as a little stream. So this would be reconnection with that moment of the past, so to say, in this now. And then we will go in the next chapter, where it would be more internal flight and something that we know by name Golden Dragon and so on. This is like a kind of my program for tonight. Though over thousands of performances, they vividly shape themselves. A divine human life which walks around and explores, and a divine human life that creates from inside out, not the opposite way. Have a good journey. Thank you. Wherever you are, whatever language you speak, whatever language you don't speak, I invite you on this trip for this experience, the only stream of 2020. from here to here, wishing well. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
To look at this world, its colors, its beauty, its diversity. Even we don't fully comprehend that, not as humans, scientifically, not as souls, based on a memory, on a remembrance, because this game is created in a particular way, and none of us, or just few, eventually, will remember the architecture of this game. And so, in this game, the diversity of animal kingdom, of flora kingdom, fauna kingdom, or queendom, and the diversity of human world with its colors and contrasts, languages, places, varieties. What happens in the story? Is a repetition that goes parallel to ongoing development and involvement, evolution. What means there is a repetition that if human will precisely look not in the books, not in the history, not in television, but in his or her own heart, human can see repetitions. Repetitions of behaviors, repetitions of emotions that come, go, come again, come, go, come again. Some say that a human need to pass some sort of examination. In that sense, it looks like there is some sort of a teacher that looks at this little one, sits there, looking at this human, and say, no, you're not allowed to go to the next level. If such is truth, everyone needs to answer to this imagination themselves. But it's not important. It's not important, and there is this teacher or God figure sitting out there. What is important, that what is sitting in here that is changing all the time, and something doesn't. But it's not the topic of this sharing right now. The point is the diversity, the variety, and the repetitions. So on the stage of a theater we call life, different characters running around playing the game, some playing good guys, some playing the bad guys. Sometimes the good guy becomes the bad guy, sometimes the bad guy becomes a good guy. And on this stage, everyone taking a role in the grand performance, a wonderful performance we all call life. At some point, some of the players can see that the play is not real. Everyone wearing a mask. Everyone sort of participates in a story, not fully understanding there is a story. And then few started to see there is a mask that everyone wearing. I'm not talking about the masks we are wearing today, some of us wearing, some of us not. I'm talking about the masks that we have been wearing until 2020. Because what happened 2020, we cannot wear them anymore. We've been placed in front of the mirror to look at ourselves. And what happens when a human looks at himself or herself into the mirror? Wow. Repetitions. So many. Some are wonderful, some are more challenging. Some of them great to look at with thanks and gratitude, but some of them difficult to look at, to find that gratitude. What happens on the stage of life if people wearing the masks see themselves? Either going to participate in the play, or they're going to create a play, maybe another kind of a play. Some call it utopia, but I wonder if to be walking around the earth with an open heart, mind, senses, does it call utopia? Is it utopia? Or maybe that's the world we all would love to live in, unconsciously striving for, wanting to live in that kind of world where our kids can walk on the street safe, where there is enough of food for everyone, where there is enough of creativity, art, creations, enough for everyone, because everything is art, everything is art. Cooking is also an art. Drawing, it's a wonderful art. Dancing, music playing, all of it. All of it. Some would say accountant is not an artist. Wow, what an art is that? Organizing things, it's an art form. So on the stage, when the participants of many kinds see themselves, would they want to continue participating in a play that is like a samsara wheel, never ending, never ending? We don't need to speak about other lives, this life, never ending repetitions. I wonder. This is just the kids sharing who do believe in some sort of utopia, which is not utopia at all. But we would need a play. We would need to go conquer more countries, control the water sources, create artificial beings to delegate them work, to create the bomb borders, to create more documents and passports. But the game will go on until those participants wouldn't see themselves. I just wonder how long, for how long this play will go on. this kind of way. an aspect of a correction. I'm not sure that there is really a great architect sitting there watching. Could be that it is just not available to us all. And maybe we will one day wake up and we'll see the matrix of it, right? That there is this great mind sitting, controlling everyone. But as for now, and as for this moment, mystery has to be presented at some point. As for now, it doesn't matter, because that's part of the game. And the correction aspect is fascinating, because a human walks on the path of life, let's say, a man or a woman, it doesn't matter. The specification for man and woman would be very different, because these are two very different universes, and primarily having at least a few very different foundations to being in the body as a man or as a woman. So what matters here is the correction aspect would be activated every time when a human walks off his or her path. There is a setting, and the human slightly goes off the path. I'm not talking about a pre-registered setting. I'm talking about a potential. Because every individual inside would know the truth, that he or she walks out of their path. How we feel it? Well, we have a split inside ourselves. One says yes, one says no. Very simple. Let's give an example. A mama or papa really wanted their child to be a doctor. Let's say, not my story, just imagining it. A lot of stories like that in this world. Or an engineer, or let's say, everyone goes to study computers, probably you need to go there and get a lot of money potentially. That's a good path to go and to become a computer scientist, right? Because everyone goes there, yeah. So let's say this human walks that path, but inside that human actually feels like painting or playing an instrument that he or she didn't play for a long time. Or being a photographer for some really great traveling magazine, let's say, that's just an example. So this division inside a human, some would call it a self-betrayal. And we all experience that, all of us, to a certain degree. We all slightly somewhere on the way betraying ourselves. And then happens the correction. It's a mystery by to align ourselves with what we are, without split. Would it be easy to be a human being? No. Would we face more challenges in life? Sure. Great correction, 2020. I would say those that see the play, which is going on stage. If we don't want to participate in that play, blindly, what do we do then? Maybe we imagine another world. Well, that's part of it. That's what we are doing right now already, this very moment, imagining different potential. How about doing actual action? I feel, I know, I observe the phenomena of absolutely incredible beings being nowadays on this planet, in every field, in science, in medicine, in arts, which is all of it anyway, but what we call arts, so to say. Politics, I feel like it will change to certain other name. What we know by politics, I don't feel is relevant at some point, because power cannot be distributed this way. And also creating revolutions, creating such disturbance to everything that it's also not the way. What would be a new way? I don't know. Maybe we all would need to imagine. We know stories, we remember stories, we've seen them in the movies, we read them in the books. We've seen them through our family, we've heard of wars, we've heard of hunger, we've heard of loss, we've heard of all kind of destructions. That's part of the play. What happens if there is a lot of humans of many kinds, just like cells of one body, part of the lungs, of the kidneys? What's the difference between all of us here and all of those cells in the body? Just a thought. This world, and yet it's also all other organs. I feel like maybe at some point the game needs to be reversed, where not the mind that rules, but everything together, considering everybody, sitting in the circle with everybody, those people who corrected themselves, that are walking their path truthfully, honestly, openly, lovingly. Soon, the fathers of the countries would find their own new playground. Because I would say, if somebody wants to be a dictator, they can be a dictator in their own little street there. No problem, right? There's enough of space for everyone. Just a thought. Some many moons ago, I've seen a dream where a tribe of people, I don't know if it was a dream or actually it was more of a vision, a tribe of people of many colors were singing and dancing for the sun god, giving life to all. And one steady, massive, incredible rhythm. And if you would listen precisely, this rhythm would be different in many parts of that circle. But the overall picture of it would have absolute unity, where everyone knows what he is, what she is, why they are here, what are they here for. Because when we do, then the theater is over. It's another beautiful play could happen, where everyone contributes, gives to it, because there is plenty for everyone through the talents, through the knowledge, through the wisdom, through the love that doesn't need anything. a kid met a sage, not on this cross the sage was hanging, but standing just in front with an open arms, saying, do you see that man on the cross behind my back? And the kid said, yes. And the sage said, that is pain that you see behind my back. You can bring that pain forward at every meeting, in every sharing, or you can leave it behind. What would you like? Thank you. last night I've been fortunate to meet a beautiful family for the Christmas. And they have beautiful children. And one of them was fascinating to watch. Of course, he was very happy to receive many gifts. He knew that there would be many gifts. And what a child that is healthy does, he's enjoying it. He loves to receive those gifts. What else he does? He gives them away. Maybe not everything. But he was happy, truly happy, to give gifts away also. There is another word for it, a present. Many misinterpret our gifts by thinking that they have to develop something, of course. But it's not the main and important thing. Gift is already there. We just have to figure which one is for us, for me, for you, for everyone. And then share it. Because if we share it and we're unhappy about it, and this word present means also, you know what, right? This moment. Such a beautiful symbology. Very. I'm going to play a little lullaby to close this evening. Not to fall asleep, rather just to relieve certain experience that we had tonight, myself included. And all my dear friends are here. I'm looking at them through ages and times and places. There is another one there, sitting, and all those I met on the way. With some of them, maybe some of you are watching it, some of you we became really good friends. With some of you we became the challengers to each other. With some of you we became lovers. With some of you we became the opposing forces. Seems that was also necessary for a certain development. So thank you for this. Maybe one day I will write about that, or something will write itself about that. I'll just be there to see it. So this little lullaby, not for falling asleep, but rather to feel. Normally I use like my little tiny guitar for that, but today I'll play this normal one. And it's shaped, that little piece shaped, I called it at that time Paris Heart. And it shaped itself by witnessing mamas and babies and grandmamas and babies and tourists and all kind of people and crazy neighbors throwing tomatoes. Right, but that development was happening there. I called it Paris Heart, but it's just the heart of any place. If we sit enough of time and observe what is happening. Fascinating. Thank you. is complete for today. From heart to heart, to many places, from here to here. Buenas noches, доброй ночи, Laila Tov, gracias, шукран, тода раба, благодарю, данкишон, габалюкас по габалюку, гидрюкас, little step at a time. Thank you, спасибо. See you.